in his hotel in Estonia, the KGB had 60 of the rooms wiped. They also had a monopoly on prostitution at the hotel. All of the prostitutes that they allowed to work at that hotel, all of them were KGB. And we know this in part. We know this in detail about the visual zone. It's a museum now. It's a museum now. The holes in the walls and the ways the KGB spied on foreigners and the blackmail tapes. It's kind of amazing, right? It's all an open secret now. Also, if you're ever in Estonia, best tourist detour ever. Go see the KGB spying on the hotel room museum. It's on the 23rd floor. And of course, now the KGB doesn't exist anymore. KGB became the FSB, which is two whole letters different from the KGB. Ultimately, the head of the FSB became this guy. And this guy got to be who he is now. This guy got to be president of Russia in a very KGB kind of way. In the immediate post-Soviet era, Boris Yeltsin was president of Russia, right? He was the first president of Russia after the Soviet Union collapsed. And when Boris Yeltsin was president of Russia, first president of the internet, Russia was a mess. Mess in lots and lots of different ways. Politically, they were a mess. They went through five different prime ministers in 3 years while Yeltsin was president. In the late 1990s, there was a powerful federal prosecutor who was looking into President Yeltsin, looking into other people in Yeltsin's government, looking into them for, allegedly, skimming off lots and lots of money into private foreign bank accounts. This prosecutor was looking into high-level corruption in the new Russian presidency. And then, lo and behold, a grainy tape turns up that shows that federal prosecutor in a hotel bed with two very young-looking prostitutes. And maybe it's just a grainy tape, and who can say if that's really the prosecutor? But then the head of the FSB came out and publicly confirmed, yes, I hereby attest, that is the prosecutor. That is definitely him. I'm the head of the KGB, I'm in the FSB, and I can hereby assure the public that this terrible person doing terrible things with these prostitutes in this terrible video, filmed in this terrible hotel room, I can hereby tell you that is this terrible prosecutor, who incidentally has been looking into corruption by the president. And so because of that grain tape, the prosecutor who's looking into Yeltsin lost his job. President Yeltsin was very thankful, and he named yet another new prime minister. He named as his new prime minister the head of the FSB, Vladimir Putin, and that put a stop to the musical chairs at the top of the Russian government. And it's never started up again because Vladimir Putin has never given up power since. How Vladimir Putin stopped just being a KGB guy and got political power in the first place was by producing at just the right time and in just the right way, just the right sex tape to use for political purposes. Today in Russia,